The oxygen sensors in your car are probably something you don't give much thought to until the problems occur. However, did you know that a defective oxygen sensor could affect your car's performance and even reduce its fuel efficiency? I'll go over some bad O2 sensor symptoms in this quick video so you can understand what's happening. I'll also tell you how much it typically costs to replace this device at the end of this video. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Check engine light illuminates. The check engine light usually illuminates as the first indication that something is amiss. When a trouble code for the oxygen sensor is present, it's common to have no other symptoms at all. The oxygen sensors are a common theme among the P30, 31, 130, 131, 132, 133, and 134 trouble codes. P137, 140, 141, 161, or 172 may also appear on your code scanner. With this in mind, you can see a wide range of error codes related to an imbalance in the air-fuel mixture, which the oxygen sensor may ultimately be to blame for. Rough idle. If the vehicle runs erratically when it is stopped or parked, the idle is off. Typically, a car should idle at 1000 RPMs or less. The oxygen sensor may not be working properly if it spikes. A rough idle, however, isn't always a sign of a malfunctioning oxygen sensor. Any component that affects the air-fuel ratio could be at fault. Because of this, you must contrast this symptom with the others. Poor motor performance. You should anticipate experiencing issues with the engine's performance if the regular combustion process is interrupted. It will be less powerful than usual, especially if you try to press the gas pedal. This issue may initially be so subtle that you fail to notice it. The issues might deteriorate further until driving becomes difficult. In order to avoid a road accident caused by the lack of acceleration, it is crucial to have the problem checked out as soon as you notice it. Decreased fuel economy. The right amount of air and fuel must be mixed inside the combustion chambers. Your faulty oxygen sensor might not be able to detect it if there is more fuel than air in the system. Your fuel efficiency declines as more fuel is burned in the engine. You will end up spending more money at the pump and visiting the gas station more frequently. Stalling engine. The motor may stall if the idle becomes too rough. This issue typically starts out as a misfire and doesn't manifest until the issue has gone unattended for a while. The engine will shut off if it can no longer generate enough power to keep running. There is no guarantee that you will be able to restart it, but you should be able to. Failed emissions test. The oxygen sensors are a component of the car's emission control system. An emissions test would be able to detect an imbalance in the exhaust if they aren't functioning. While there are many reasons to fail these required tests, the oxygen sensors frequently are a significant offender. When the test fails, have the computer checked for codes that could indicate the source of the issue. Strange sounds. An excessive amount of carbon could accumulate in the combustion chamber when an oxygen sensor fails to monitor the air-fuel mixture. The motor's mixture could run lean as a result of this issue. Lean mixtures result in pre-ignition, which causes knocking or pinging noises. However, other factors, such as a clogged fuel injector, poor fuel, or engine damage, can also cause these noises. These noises are typically audible when the engine is under load. Catalytic converter failure. What happens if you keep using the system even though the oxygen sensor is malfunctioning? The imbalance of air and fuel will eventually cause the catalytic converter to malfunction. To prevent harm to the catalytic converter, the oxygen sensors must be functioning at their best. A catalytic converter replacement is never inexpensive. You should replace the faulty oxygen sensor just because it leads to more serious issues. Oxygen sensor replacement cost. For an oxygen sensor replacement, you might expect to pay $50 to $450 on average. However, this price is solely determined by a number of variables. The cost is greatly influenced by the kind of vehicle and engine you drive. Driving a small, affordable car will likely cost you much less than driving a larger SUV or truck. Luxury automobiles also have more expensive components, which raises the overall cost. The labor rate is the other significant factor. There is no need to hire a qualified mechanic if you can replace the oxygen sensor yourself. You can save a lot of money by figuring this out on your own, given that the oxygen sensor may only cost you $20 to $175. When it comes to these fixes, a service manual or repair manual is very useful. The issue arises when you put off replacing the oxygen sensors. By putting off this repair, you run the risk of allowing additional damage to occur. As a result, a straightforward repair can easily become something more expensive. I always advise replacing the faulty oxygen sensor at the first sign of trouble because of this.